We've established earlier that enzymes do not change the equilibrium concentrations of a chemical reaction, nor do they change whether, given enough time, the formation of product is energetically favored or the reverse reaction, the formation of substrate. What enzymes do change is to accelerate the rate at which we're getting there. So let's look at the kinetics of a chemical reaction. In a simple process of S turning into P, we analyze the kinetics of the reaction by measuring the rate of formation of product over time. That is expressed typically as delta P over delta T, meaning a change in the concentration of P over a unit time. Delta P over delta T equals V, the velocity or rate of the reaction, and that in turn, for the simple conversion of S to P given above, equals the product of the concentration of S and small k, the rate constant for this reaction. So for this simple process, the rate equation shows that the velocity or rate of reaction is proportional to the concentration of S, with k being a constant. This rate constant is specific for each reaction. Experimentally, we can determine this rate constant by measuring the formation of product P over time for different concentrations of substrate S. We can, for example, measure the concentration of P by spectrophotometry. For all these concentrations, the rate at which P is formed will initially be linear and then level off because S is being used up, and eventually there is no net formation of product. The initial rate of reaction, V0, can be read from the linear early part of the curves. As you see, V0 is proportional to S. The bigger the concentration of substrate, the faster the initial rate, V0. If we plot this correlation, V0, against the concentration of S, we get a linear correlation for simple reversible reactions S to P, with forward rate constant K1 and reverse rate constant K-1. The slope of the graph on the left is equal to K1. However, if we do this for enzyme reactions, even for simple ones that just convert one molecule of S to one molecule of P, we get this kind of correlation between V0 and S. What's happening there? Even a simple enzymatic reaction happens in two steps. First, the association of enzyme and substrate to an enzyme-substrate complex ES, and then the conversion of enzyme-bound substrate to product, which is then released. The first step is reversible, with rate constants K1 and K-1, and the second step is, for simplicity, considered irreversible, with a rate constant K2. At least at the beginning, where we measure V0, there is too little product around, so the reverse reaction happens at a negligible rate. The first step is simple binding or association of enzyme and substrate, rather like drug and receptor, and is typically very fast. The second step is the actual catalysis, and is much slower. This is typically the rate-limiting step of an enzymatic reaction. So to reiterate, for a simple chemical reaction, the initial velocity is directly proportional to the substrate concentration via V0 equals K times S. There is a linear correlation, and we call this first-order kinetics. For enzyme-catalyzed reactions, the V0 versus S plot is hyperbolic. At low concentrations of substrate, V0 increases linearly with S, and we have more or less first-order kinetics. At much higher concentrations of S, though, the reaction becomes practically independent of the substrate concentration, and that is what we call zero-order kinetics. This behavior comes from the fact that the reaction happens in the active site of an enzyme. This kind of curve, a so-called rectangular hyperbola, that gets ever closer to a maximum value on the y-axis, is typically described with an equation of y equals ax over b plus x. You can easily see that for very large x, meaning much larger than b, the two x terms are going to cancel each other out, and y equals a. In our case here, that value is the maximal velocity, Vmax. The other value, b in this equation, is Km, the Michaelis constant. Km is equal to the concentration of S, at which the initial rate V0 is half of the maximal rate Vmax. If you look at the equation and substitute S for Km, you can easily see that the term S over Km plus S becomes 1/2. So V0 equals 1/2 Vmax. The equation V0 equals Vmax times S over Km plus S is the so-called Michaelis Menten equation. It's worth pausing the video here to look at it more closely. Play around with it and see what fraction of the maximal rate Vmax you get for substrate concentrations that are, for example, 1/2 Km or twice Km. Of course, you know already now that for S equals Km, the initial rate is exactly half of Vmax.